Tell me lies. They had something like that, didn't they? Tell me lies. That's going to be Missy Messy Nutmeg's theme song. Tell me lies. And let's get to the video because, wow, so many lies. It's the Lion Queen. Did you get it? The Lion Queen. It's not the Lion King. The Lion Duchess of Sussex. Sex. Let's get to it. So, what was the latest news on Missy Messy Nutmeg? Oh boy. Yeah, I'm always searching for the fake news. It's the lying game. I have it all written down because there's so much junk. So let's go first for the palace. Let's talk about the palace, Buckingham Palace. Buckingham Palace looks like it's going under construction. It only looks like because it's not going under construction. It has a guard in the front. The windows are all shut. The crest is out. Okay. You know why? That's for not Missy Messy to go there and because she is on her way out to La La Land for good. Yeah, it's... They're not together. They're not playing house. They're not with the real baby. They are not, you know, manipulating the royal family. They are, please believe me, they are not. She's the only mastermind of this whole junk. And the poor kid, you know, the kid. Yeah, he's just going with the flow, I mean, it's his last chance to be a royal in this life. So, yeah, you better watch out here. So let's move. That's why Buckingham Palace is all shut up. Shut up. Oh, they're trying to shut up. No, there's a guard. There's no crest. The guard is there to, you know, Missy's here, Missy is there. Remember when she was walking around the gardens and they had to call the police? The police? Yeah, remember. So moving on, let's go because, yeah, today, woo! Another side note that the Queen's reign is effectively over due to the disease because it's too risky for her to resume her job. And the disease, you know, practically put Charles on the throne. Okay, maybe. So Missy Messy must be now planning, you know, to grab Charles and kick Camilla out of her way. Missy, do not dare do that because Camilla kicked somebody out of her way. Yeah, just don't forget about that. And you know what happened. So you better not mess with Camilla. Do not mess with Lady Camilla. The Duchess Camilla. Okay, yeah. So Charles is going to take over. Missy Messy is going to, you know, take over Charles. She will do everything to take over Charles. More fake news is coming up. Tell me lies. I want more lies. Lies about Missy Messy. Where's the lies about Missy Messy? She was out. One of the Queen's first Zoom, the Queen takes part in a video call from Windsor Castle as she joins Princess Anne in May in marking Careers Week with virtual messages of thanks. Okay. I'm telling you, it's Monty. This speaks volumes. The Queen took part of a Zoom call, you know, all over with her daughter. But where is the Zoom call of, you know, Missy Messy Nutmeg congratulating her for her husband's birthday? There is no Zoom call whatsoever. There was no baby Archie saying, happy birthday, grandpa, happy birthday, great grandpa, happy birthday, great grandpa, or whatever. Yeah. So more lies. Oh my gosh, so many lies. Liar. Okay. Harry and Missy planned to run away from royalty way before they got married. Tell me more lies. I want more lies. To make up more lies. I want more. Tell me lies, Missy. Woo! Woman, do you lie? You lie so much, it's embarrassing. Okay, so let's go for that one, because this one is amazing. They already planned it way before. So she's like a psychic, because the Megxit was already planned way before they got married, but she forgot one little thing. The Megxit was a viral, I think it was on Twitter, correct me if I am wrong, way before, when they were, you know, when nobody was liking Missy very much. They were like, you know, go away, woman, go away, please get out of our lives. You're spending our money buying clothes and shoes and reselling everything and put it in inside your pocket, and then you send a transfer to La La Land. Yeah, everybody knew about that. When that started to happen, the thing was, somebody, I think it was a tweet, as I said, it went viral because it was the time of the Brexit, and they called it Megxit. Now Missy is claiming that Megxit She was, you know, they were talking about Megxit way before they got married. Oh my gosh, tell me more lies, Missy, more lies, more lies. You're a lying queen, lady. Oh, you're really over the top with your lies, Pope. Don't you get tired of lying so much? It's tiring because when people lie, they don't know the truth. So, you know, it's lie on top of lies. Yeah, I'm not going to teach you all these things. Here it is. Meghan Markle and Prince Harry openly discussed Megxit before Mary. Liar, liar. A pants on fire. Because the Duke was deeply unhappy for a long time. Lies. Because his life, he had a wonderful life. He had an amazing life. He had all the money in the world. He had all the protection in the world. He had his family, his brother, his granny, his sister-in-law that was like his sister. He had his jewels, his mommy's jewels. He had all the girlfriends he wanted. He had all the fame and everybody after him. Harry, Harry, Harry. Cool Harry, cool Harry. He was the cool Harry. So please, he was very, very happy, Missy. He was very... Meghan Markle, 38, still, yeah, 38. She's going on 36 on next month or whatever. Okay, source said biography, but yeah, the book. That's why they want the book before Lady C. It's not coming out, lady. It is not coming out before Lady C, okay? Source said biography will make clear that Megxit was far from a snap decision. Yeah, okay, more lies. Don't you get tired of all these lies? I get fighting freedom. Okay, the book's coming out August 11th. Lady C's book is coming earlier. Okay. The Duke and the Duchess of Sussex discussed Megxit before they got married because the Duke was deeply unhappy for a long time. Oh, Harry, why do you let her do that? Please, somebody, get this man, get the drones, get those drones. Grab Harry by the hair. By the head, because there's no, by the head, you know, when you push him like that, yeah, and take him away ASAP, please, because you see all so many lies. Ooh, okay. This was the best part. This is, oh my gosh, this part was amazing. I mean, the lie went up to the top. Yeah, it went up to the top. Prince Harry, 35, and Meghan Markle, 38, still are currently living, lies, in TP's mansion. That's $18 million. Okay. It was 24 million pounds that if you go to exchange rates, you know, exchange rate, you calculate that, it doesn't go to $18 million. It goes way more than $18 million. So, more lies. So now that the property is going down, I wonder why. It's because Missy Messy was walking around there. Nobody's going to want to buy that thing, that giant elephant there. Okay, the sources. Obin Scobin. Okay, now reveal the bombshell. Harry and Meghan and Making of a Modern Family book. That's the book. Another lie. An insider in OS. Okay? Omid. An insider told The Sun the seeds of Megxit were sown before they even got married. Remember that Charity had a trademark for Archie. Before she got married, or even before she met Harry, she already trademarked, she patented the name Archie. So her baby shower was for a girl, but she patented 3 years earlier the name Archie. Isn't this woman cray-cray? I mean, this is really getting to a point where, you know, it's dangerous. Her mind is really, you know, she really lives in La La Land, Fantasy Land, Disneyland, whatever. That's why she was, you know, she's the lying Duchess of Sex, okay. Is this a face of a man who's unhappy? Please, is this a face of a man who is unhappy? I don't think so. This is it. Co-author, O.S. Mitskobi. Yeah, Scooby-Doo. Who has accompanied Prince Harry and Meghan on a variety of royal tours. I've never seen him anywhere, you know, like shown his little face that we don't know if he's a doll. He looks like a doll, an AI doll. He does. Sorry. Openly told the podcast, the tale has included twists and turns that even the Sussexes didn't expect. Yeah, okay, the twists and turns that. Now let's get down to the real royal truth. The twists and turns were they did not expect the Queen to strip down his military medals and titles and money and castles and her tiaras. And she said, give me back everything, Missy. You give me back all my jewels. They are mine. They are not yours. They don't belong to you. They belong to the people of the United Kingdom. Police. Missy. So did not expect. That's what they didn't expect, that they would be stripped down of everything. She wanted to plan everything. Marry out Harry, or she didn't get the good looking one, or, you know, the daddy, which has a lot of it. So she didn't get that. She was stuck with the red hair one, with the, oh yeah, a little bit of red hair one. Yeah, the younger, the silly one. Harry. So she married Harry. She pretended a baby because if she had an heir, she would get more money and then she would get the jewels and blah, 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 blah. After all this junk that she was a mind master, she would kick everybody, grab the silly one, let's go to La La Land because I am going to be famous and I'm going to be a billionaire, trillionaire, and I'm going to wear my crowns, the red carpet's going to be stretched out for me, me, me. You can accompany me and hold my hand back. Oh, that's where her plans. Her plans went down the drain so fast, like, you know, a quicksand. She was standing on a quicksand. The problem is she grabbed her prince and she also put him standing on a quicksand. I guess that little drone got him, you know, like this and took him away. She's all alone standing on her quicksand. So what's going to happen if somebody stands on a quicksand? This is what's going to happen if you stand on a quicksand. And that is it. That is it. Help! Help!